We have now discussed the design considerations and the manufacturing process of crystalline silicon solar cells. In this video, we will shortly introduce the technical considerations for manufacturing solar modules from wafer-based crystalline silicon cells. In a solar module, the individual cells are interconnected in a circuit. Cells can be placed in series, in parallel, or in a combination of both. This will affect the voltage and current output of the module. Furthermore, when one or multiple cells of the modules are shaded, the IV characteristic of the module will change and problems will arise. These must be tackled by using bypass diodes. Finally, we will discuss the standard structure of a crystalline silicon solar module, where encapsulation is an important step to protect the solar modules from weather influences. Up to now, we have discussed the design considerations of single solar cells. The dimensions of such cells are usually 6 by 6 inch or 15.5 by 15.5 centimeters. A solar module consists of many solar cells interconnected in a circuit. As of today, the most frequently used design has 60 individual cells with a total dimension of 1 by 1.65 meters. In PV systems, these modules will again be interconnected to form an array. In order to connect individual solar cells in a module, the bus bars at the front side will be connected to the back contact of the neighboring cell. This process is called contact tabbing. Here you see a cross-sectional view of a few solar cells connected in series. Such a series connection is called a string. There are other ways to interconnect solar cells, such as the metal wrap-through technology. Here the front contacts are wrapped through the cell with a so-called via, such that both positive and negative terminals are located at the backside of the cell. The cells can now be placed much closer to each other since contact tabbing is omitted. A more advanced way to place all contacts at the backside of the solar cell is found in the interdigitated back contactor technology. Both the electrons and holes will be collected at the backside of the cell by alternately placing P+ and N+ layers that serve as selective contacts. We will now demonstrate the difference in series or parallel connection by looking at the IV curve of the resulting circuits. Based on the requirements of the manufacturer and consumer, the optimal layout can be found. A single crystalline silicon-based solar cell has an open circuit of in between 0.6 and 0.7 volts, depending on the technology and quality of the wafer. The current produced by each cell is determined by the photocurrent and thus the light intensity incident on each cell. At one sun illumination, the short circuit current of a single cell is between 8 and 9 amperes. In a series connection, the voltage of the cells is added, while the current flow through each cell is equal, similar to a series connection of batteries. This current is controlled by the cell that produces the lowest photocurrent. In a parallel connection, the voltage is the same of all cells. Now the current produced by the cells adds up. Adding the IV curves of the three solar cells will then give a total of 3 times ISC of current, while the voltage of the circuit is equal to the VOC of one cell. This means that if we consider a module, we can partly tune the voltage and the current output by choosing series connection, parallel connection, or a combination. We have to notice that when we consider the power that is transported towards an inverter, it is preferential to transport low currents and at a high voltage to reduce power loss in connections and cables. If we consider the following module of 36 cells, all are connected in series. The output of the module will be 36 times the open circuit voltage of a single cell. If we would rearrange the connection of this module, we can obtain a different current and voltage output. Two strings of 18 cells will result in a short circuit current of 2 times that of a single cell, thus 17 amperes. The open circuit voltage of the module would then be 18 times that of a single cell, which is 10.8 volts. We will now shortly address a problem that comes up when multiple cells are connected in a string to form a PV module. When the module is installed in a PV system, it can be partially shaded by a nearby object such as a tree, a chimney, or a neighboring building. Shading can also be caused by a leaf that has fallen from a tree. This seems harmless, but it can have significant consequences for the output of the solar module and can even cause overheating if no measures were taken. We will demonstrate this in a current voltage graph of these six cells. This graph shows the theoretical IV curve of the five non-shaded cells in series, adding to a total of 5 times VOC. The shaded cell will produce less current than the other 5 cells, therefore it will have a lower short circuit current. For simplicity, we will assume that the open circuit voltage of the shaded cell is unaffected. In this example, we had a constant load R. This means that the voltage of the module is dropping due to the lower current generation. The 5 non-shaded cells will now be forced to produce high voltages and will act like a reverse bias source on the shaded solar cell. The dashed black line represents the reverse bias load that is placed on the shaded cell. This is the IV curve of the 5 non-shaded cells mirrored to the vertical axis at 0 volts. A reverse bias over the shaded cell in fact means that it will start dissipating power and heat up. If the temperature of the cell is increased to a critical level, the encapsulation of the cell might crack or wear out. This can be prevented with so-called bypass diodes. Such a bypass diode will block a current flow under negative bias, but will start conducting current under positive bias. In the example, in the case that one cell is shaded, the bypass diode is biased by the 5 non-shaded cells and will start conducting current. As a result, the current can bypass the shaded cell and will not dissipate power. The PV module can now still produce power. Before we conclude this video, we will show the basic structure of a crystalline silicon solar module. On the back side of the module, a junction box is placed that encloses the string interconnects and brings out a positive and negative terminal cable that can be connected to an inverter or to other solar modules to form an array. The junction box is located underneath a plastic or glass backsheet. The solar cells itself are laminated between 2 layers of encapsulation foil to prevent air and moisture ingress. The most common encapsulation material is ethylene vinyl acetate or EVA. The front surface of the module is protected with a sheet of tempered glass to make the module impact resistant. Finally, the sides are protected with an aluminium frame such that the module can be mounted on support structures. To summarize this video, we have discussed the technical consideration going from cell level to module level. Solar cells will be placed in series or parallel connection to increase either the voltage or current output of the module respectively. When the module is installed outside, problems caused by shading are addressed and can be prevented by the use of bypass diodes. And finally, encapsulation of the solar cells is important to improve the weather and impact resistance of the module.